In this lecture, we will look at making local adjustments using the U-point technology. I have opened Beach Local. In this image, I want to bring some texture back in the white sand. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection. I will use Vivesa again, so I click on OK. I only want to adjust the sand. To select the sand, I click on the Add a Control Point button. Now I click in the sand. The small circle with the yellow edge is the control point. Under it, there are the sliders we also have at the right. With the top slider, I can increase or decrease the area of influence, which is the circle. Inside the circle, the sand is selected. I want to increase the area of influence so that all the sand is selected. Now I will increase the structure. I click on Preview at the top. I can see I have only adjusted the sand. Let's place another control point. I click on the Add a Control Point button and click in the sky. I will now lighten the sky. I drag the brightness slider. To select more of the sky, I make the area of influence larger. I can click on the sand control point to work on the sand and click on the sky control point to work on the sky. If I click on control point list at the right, I can see my two control points, control point 1 and control point 2. I am also able to see the mask that Vivesa has made by clicking on Show Hide Selection of Control Point at the right of a control point. This is the selection for the sand, and this is the selection for the sky. We will continue the exploration of control points with the next image. I click on Save. In GIMP, we now have the original and adjusted layer. This means we are still able to bring some areas back to the original image by using a layer mask. To do this, I right-click on the adjusted layer on top and choose Add Layer Mask. I fill it with white. To remove an adjusted area, I can paint with black on the mask. If I lower the opacity of the brush, I create transparency and start blending the layers. I have opened Girl Crop. I would like to make the face and the arms of the girl a bit lighter. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection. This time I will open the image in Color Effects Pro 4. I click on OK. Color Effects is a filter collection with more than 50 filters. It is used for color corrections, retouching, and creative effects. When you open Color Effects, the last filter you used, which in my case is the sunlight filter, is shown at the right. We will look at the sunlight filter in the next lecture. At the left side, you can choose a filter. Each filter has some presets from which you can choose. If you are in preset mode, this is the preset mode icon and I will click on it. Click on the back button to go to list mode to see all filters displayed. Right now I see all 55 filters. If I click on, for example, the landscape tab, I see the filters that are closely related to landscape images. I like to see all the filters, so I click on All again. At the right, I will remove the sunlight filter by clicking on the little cross at the right. Now I see my image without any adjustments. The filter I will use for the image is Levels and Curves. I will click on it. In Color Effects, the control points are placed at the bottom of a filter. There are two types of control points in Color Effects: plus and minus control points. The plus control point is a normal control point. We will look at the minus control point in a moment. I will place a control point on the girl's face and adjust the area of influence. If I now adjust the curve at the right, I see I am only adjusting the girl's face. Now let's brighten up her arms. I can place a new control point, but I can also reuse the control point I already have by duplicating it. I can duplicate a control point in three ways. First, I can press Ctrl D. By pressing Delete, I will delete the control point again. The second way is by clicking on the text Control Points at the right. At the bottom right, I have a Duplicate and Delete button. I click on the control point I want to duplicate, and then I click on the Duplicate button. I delete it again. The third way is the fastest way. When I hold down Alt and drag a control point, I duplicate the control point while I drag. I will make the area of influence a bit bigger. For the arm, I want to reduce the strength of the effect a bit. In Color Effects, a control point has an opacity slider. I will drag it down to about 70%. If you experience undesired spilling of a control point to the surroundings, you could do the following. I will make the area of influence a bit smaller and use this control point for the top of the arm. I alt-drag the control point and place it at the lower part of the arm. Now I have the whole arm covered with two smaller control points. If I want to adjust the opacity of the right arm, it would be efficient to have both control points to act as one. I can do this by grouping the control points. To group the control points, I select the control points I want to group. I do this by shift-clicking on them. The first selected control point becomes the control point that will control the other control points. Now that I have the control points selected, at the right I click on Group the Selected Control Points button. I now have a group of control points named Group 1. If I adjust the main control point, I also change the other control point. You can also ungroup a group again by selecting the group and clicking on the Ungroup Control Points button. I will alt-drag a control point over to the left arm. To compare the before and after, at the top I can click on the Compare button. Now let's have a look at the minus control point. We have seen how to combine smaller control points to minimize the spill when needed. If this wouldn't be enough, you can also use minus control points. To show how they work, let's have a look at the masks themselves. At the right, I click on Show Hide selection for all control points. We now see the mask. Under it, I can hide and show the individual control points by clicking on the Show Hide selection of control points icon. To remove the light spill we see here, I will now place a minus control point. I click on it and click on the left of the girl's face. I will increase the area of influence. I can do the same at the bottom. I click on the minus control point button again and click at the bottom. And lastly, I take a minus control point and place it at the left side of her arm to subtract from the selection. I click on the Show Hide selection for all control points again to exit the mask view. By dragging in my curve, I see I now have a very refined mask. Now let's say I want to make the skin tone a bit warmer. I could go into the blue channel and adjust it, but I will use another filter for this. I will drag the placed point of the blue channel again. I will add the brilliance warmth filter. I can add a new filter in two ways. The first method is to click at the bottom on the Add Filter button. Then I go to the left side and choose a filter by clicking on it. I will delete the filter again by clicking on the little cross. With the second method, you can skip the Add Filter button and directly add a new filter by shift-clicking on it. When you use this second method, be careful not to click on a filter without holding shift, because this will remove the last added filter. Let me show you. I click on the Brilliance Warmth filter without holding shift. Brilliance Warmth has now replaced the Levels and Curves filter. I will press Ctrl-Z to undo. Now I will shift click on Brilliance Warmth. The filter is now added to the filter list. There is also a history panel. We can see the last action, which is in orange, is Brilliance Warmth added. Like in GIMP, I can select an earlier state and continue from there. To exit the history panel, I click at the top on the Color Effects Pro 4 tab. I will shift-click on Brilliance Warmth again to edit. What I would like to do is to reuse the control points that I have made under Levels and Curves. To select all control points, I can drag over the image or I can press Ctrl-A. To copy the control points, I click on the menu icon at the right and choose Copy Control Points. Now I go to Brilliance Warmth. I click on the menu icon again and choose Paste Control Points. I have now copied the control points over. If I drag the warmth slider to the right, I am only affecting the skin. I can show and hide the Brilliance Warmth filter by clicking on the check mark at the left of the filter name. I can also hide the effect for an individual control point by clicking on the check mark of a control point. Control point 1 is the control point for the face. To zoom in, press the space bar. To zoom out, press the space bar again. You can change the zoom percentage at the top by clicking on the triangle icon. To pan, like in Viveza, hold the spacebar pressed down and drag with the mouse.